So, do you think that ZTE's new Axon M, its foldable device, will be the next best thing? Will this take on and you'll see Samsung copy it? I doubt it, but it does make things interesting. If you haven't yet heard or seen our hands-on, the ZTE Axon M is now available to order through AT&T. The foldable phone will run you $725 or $24.17 per month for 30 months on AT&T's installment plan. AT&T states that orders will ship between November 6th and 8th, and in-store availability is slated for November 17th. Now, to recap the specs, the ZTE Axon M features two 5.2-inch 1080p displays, a Snapdragon 821 processor, 4 GB of RAM, dual speakers with Dolby Audio, and a single 20-megapixel camera. The device is a full screen on the front and back, but can be folded out to extend or mirror your screen to the second display. Now, no, I don't think the device itself is very interesting. Kind of cool, but I don't think it's going to catch on. It's just not practical. What is practical and really interesting is AT&T's installment plan. I mean, is this what it is on face value, or are they leaving out some murky details conveniently? If you do the math, $725 divided by 30 months is $24 and change. Kind of what they're saying the installment plan is now. Are they going to charge you no interest for that installment plan? That would be crazy. And if so, could they do that with other flagship devices? Instead of having to have $1,200 in the bank account to buy a new S8, could you do an installment plan like that with no interest? Or I'm okay with interest, just be a little bit of interest. Like, don't slay us like carriers have done in the past. I think that's the real story. Pump that, AT&T. What do you guys think? And good news for all you Asus fans in the West, because the Asus Zenfone 4 lineup is now available, or will be soon available, in North America. It's official. North America will see a release of the Zenfone 4 Pro, the Zenfone 4, and the Zenfone 4 Max. All three phones feature dual camera setups, physical home buttons, and a design language, but that's where the similarities end. The flagship device of the bunch is the Asus Zenfone 4 Pro. It features a Qualcomm Snapdragon 835 processor, 6 GB of RAM, 64 GB of storage, and the 5.5-inch AMOLED display comes in at 1080p with Gorilla Glass 5 covering for scratch resistance. The dual camera setup is a 12-megapixel shooter next to a 16-megapixel lens with 2x optical zoom. For selfie fans, the front-facing camera is an 8-megapixel shooter with phase detection, autofocus, and HDR. The Asus Zenfone 4 Pro has a 3600 mAh battery, Android 7.1.1 Nougat, and is priced at $599 US. You can grab it at Asus Store, Amazon, BHV Video, Best Buy, and Newegg. Now, if you're looking for a solid mid-ranger, the Asus Zenfone 4 might be up your alley. It has a Qualcomm Snapdragon 626 processor, 4 GB of RAM, 64 GB of onboard storage, a 5.5-inch 1080p IPS display. It keeps the same main 12-megapixel lens from the Zenfone 4 Pro, but pairs it with an 8-megapixel lens that has 120-degree field of view with wide-angle shots. And because Asus wanted to confuse everyone, the final device is the Asus Zenfone 4 Max, which comes with two displays. The Zenfone 4 Max has either a 5.5-inch 720p or 5.2-inch 720p display. The larger of the two devices features a 5,000 mAh battery, with the smaller featuring a 4,100 mAh battery. Both phones have a 13-megapixel plus a 5-megapixel camera setup on the rear of the device, with an 8-megapixel shooter on the front. Interestingly enough, though, the front-facing camera has a flash too. You can grab the Asus Zenfone 4 Max at 5.5 inches for $199. And the Asus Zenfone 4 Max at 5.2 inches will run you $169. Now, what I want to talk about is a new phone that is designed from the ground up to be a gaming beast, and that's the new Razer phone. Now, if you're in need of a smartphone that can handle pretty much any game you throw at it, look no further than the Razer phone. With its big display, massive battery, and impressive audio features, the Razer phone specs should be able to deliver anything you need out of a game-focused device. The Razer phone specs include a 5.71-inch quad HD LCD, 120Hz display, a Qualcomm Snapdragon 835 mobile platform, 8GB of RAM, 64GB of storage, a microSD expansion up to 2TB, count it, 2TB. It also comes with a 4,000mAh battery, dual rear-facing 12MP cameras, stereo front-facing speakers, dual amplifiers, and an audio adapter with THX-certified DAC. Basically, the thing is a gaming beast. Now, you see, I came from a PC era where you built your rig. You know, we called it a rig like it was a truck because it took so much space and there was so much gear in it, it was almost like a truck. And we would game on that PC. And every, you know, 6 to 9 months, you'd have to upgrade a big component on the motherboard because you just had to keep up with everyone else. And it was an immersive experience. Never did I ever imagine that there would be a similar gaming culture on a small little device like that. But my twin boys, who are 17 years old right now, have proven me wrong because they love to play games on their 5.5-inch displays. Is this exciting for you guys? How much do you care about this? Let me know in the comments below. I would like to hear it, or right there on Twitterverse. Now, my audience is smart. So smart that sometimes you're inspired by a business idea, and then you try and get the name of that business in a domain name. And your next prospective customer is searching your business name and they assume you have the .com. And if you don't, you're giving your business away to the one who does. That's the power of a .com. Now, why is that exactly? Well, no domain name extension tells your story with the same degree of trust as a .com or .net domain name. .com and .net domain name extensions inject credibility into your online presence. And who doesn't want to be credible? And don't forget, you get 15% off when you use our coupon code ANDROID. When you think domain names, think domain.com.